Hello everyone and welcome back to Veluwe Zoo. Yes, it's happening again. What is this? You're uploading a video almost every week now. Yes, because this is the second video in 2 weeks time of Veluwe Zoo, which is amazing. Everyone was waiting for this and I was waiting to finish this project and we're finally doing it. So in the previous episode, we built a wonderful habitat for the giant anteaters. Yes. And yeah, it was nice. A lot of temple pieces, a lot of faux rocks. And with that, we finished off the South America area, basically. Although we are adding another building today. We are actually adding two buildings today, which are both monorail stations. So if you have ever seen a live stream, we already did like two or three. We already did three monorail stations in Veluwe Zoo. I never made a video out of that. They are available on the workshop though. And a lot of people were there while we were building them on a live stream. But today we are building them in a video, which is really nice. So I can show you guys what we do with these monorail stations. I'm using the same layout for all of them, but the theming is a little bit different. So today we are adding the one in the North America section and the one in the South America section. So we're doing both America. How cool is that? Yeah, not very. But anyway, the building itself, look at this, a lot of Arctic wood. This looks a little bit weird, this wall, so I removed it later, so you will have an open staircase, which looks a lot better. I'm trying to add as much detail as possible for these kind of things, but yeah, it's kind of a weird shape, you know, these monorail stations, and I'm not really sure, yeah, what is the best way to make them. But in the end, I like the way they look throughout the park. They all have their own theme on it. So we have the Australia one, we have a modern one, we have a classical one, and yeah, with this we have the North America one with more like a log style cabin kind of thing. See, a lot of logs, a lot of wood for this one. Just adding the rail for the staircase, make sure people don't drop down, very important. And yeah, we'll just continue to this building. And yeah, so the couple of things that we have to talk about. Veluwe Zoo, of course, everyone is wondering what is happening now. Are you actually finishing it? Yes, and I actually already finished it. And we still have one more video for you guys after this one. So there will be this monorail thing. I think we also discussed this in the previous video, but I don't care. We're doing it again. But yeah, we are doing this monorail station and then we have another video with like finishing touches. There were a couple of interiors that we still had to do. The interior of the main building. And there was a gift shop that was still empty. I made it not that much effort into it, I'm gonna admit. But there is an interior, you know, little gift shop items here and there from the workshop that I used. And I'm not much of a, like a, how should I say it? Like these prop thing making, that's not my thing. That's too tedious and I just like to make some buildings, habitat, that's all good. But I'm not gonna make like a fluffy bear out of 300,000 pieces and make a video out of that. That's not really my thing. So I'm just using some blueprints for that one. But you will see it in the next video. And I've been thinking about a tour and a cinematic video and I decided to do both, yes. But we're gonna do the tour on a live stream. I think that's the best way to do it. There will be some interaction with you guys. And if you have questions about the zoo or whatever, I can answer them. And maybe I cannot, I don't know. We will see, hopefully I can. And then we will do a cinematic video and with that we also release it to the Steam Workshop. How exciting is that? Yeah, that was the final motivation for me to finally, you know, getting back into it so I'm able to share the zoo with you guys once it's finished. And we are almost there. There's a couple of small things I have to do, like the some foliage, some fencing, but I did like 95% of it already, and that will be put in a video and that will be up there for you guys a week after this one, I guess. Yes, trying to upload something every Sunday from now on. Yeah, that's gonna be a goal. I know I've been slacking a lot, like months of no uploads, and yeah, it's a waste. It was a waste, and I know you guys have been following me. We had 7,500 subscribers here, which I'm really grateful and thankful and everything. And I need to give you guys some content, of course, to enjoy. And we just got a new pack announced. How cool is that? So yeah, the Africa pack. I already started to make some videos for that one. We're gonna do a new park, which is exciting. We don't have a name yet, but while I'm recording this, there's already a contest going on in which you can submit your name suggestion for that zoo, and we're gonna use it for the series, and you can win a Africa DLC pack. How exciting! Yeah, but once this video is out, the deadline was already there, so I'm not really sure why I'm saying this, just because there is no name for it yet. Not much to say about that. It's gonna be like a South African conservation area, mainly focused about white rhinos, and after that they added a few more animals, and we'll see how far we will get. While I'm recording this, I've already finished two habitats, and so that's two videos actually, and I'm enjoying it. I think it looks nice. It's a completely different style than Veluwe Zoo, and that's what I was going for. That's good, I think. And it's gonna be speed build videos again. Not like Ruma Asia that we do like a showcase, because we put so much time and effort into that one. It's almost impossible to make a speed build out of that. And I'm gonna try it anyway with the new project. I am putting a lot of more details in it than in Veluwe Zoo, and more for like going more for like realistic stuff. Very important. And yeah. Anyway, this build I've been talking about. Whatever, and not really about this build. You can see I'm using a lot of locks, closing off this side, switching this one from the group. It looks a bit boring from the back, but I don't really care for this one. I'm putting some lights in and some beams, some wooden beams everywhere, making sure that the staircase, the pathing covered up staircase looks nice. And you can see it already starting to look like an actual monorail station. Putting some flooring in, there's some toilets underneath them. There's actually all of them have these toilets in them. I think that's cool. Very nice if you have like a franchise zoo. So it's a thing that you forget. Toilets, very important. People need to pee while they're in a zoo. So yeah, we need toilets. And oh, there we are in the second monorail station. It was actually placed in a weird spot. And I was thinking I can do like another lock style thing, like tropical vibes giving it, but I can also do like temple pieces, and I love temple pieces, so yeah, we're gonna do temple pieces. How often am I gonna say temple pieces? Very often, yes. A staircase. I'm doing the layout exactly the same as all the other ones. You can see it, make sure the terrain is a little bit raised so the path is connecting, and the exit on the back, and it's going back to the front, so where you can connect the path again. How amazing is this? Yeah, after watching these videos, you can make a monorail station yourself, I think. Because we did two of them in one video. I first wanted to split the videos, but that would be like 2 7-minute videos. That's a bit of a... Yeah, I don't know. And there's not much happening. I know, it's called Planet Zoo and Veluwe Zoo. And it's not called Planet Monorail Station, so... Not sure how... excited you are about monorail stations, but let me know down in the comments if you like it, if you want to see more videos like this, because I do know people are struggling with these kind of buildings. I always see like there's the same kind of stuff that people are making for this, not putting much time and effort in it. Not that I did that, but yeah, I think this one actually looks kind of cool in the end with the temple pieces. Yes, temple pieces. I'm saying it again, why not? Yeah, okay, on this side, doing the same thing, you know, the gates, the windows, nice little details on this one with the beams, another even bigger beam, and another big beam, very nice. Yeah, same layout, same stuff, same roof, same everything, But it's cool. It's finishing off the zoo, you know. I'm putting some extra detail into this one to make it blend in with the South America section a little bit better. I think it comes out really nicely. I hope you guys like it. If you want me to put them on the workshop, I'm gonna try to do it before this video is released. Putting things on a Steam workshop is a pain in the bum. I have to admit, you need to have like screenshots from it, but they are not allowed to be bigger than 2 megabytes, which is stupid. You can only upload one picture at a time. So it really takes you like 20-25 minutes to put something on the workshop. Then you have to make a good blueprint and see if it works and put some instructions down for it. I don't know. I wish they could make it a bit more easy. You know, no file limit, no upload several pictures at the same time. That kind of stuff. That would be nice. You know, I know it's not up to Frontier. It's all up to Steam probably. Oh yeah. Yeah, I would like that. I would definitely put more effort into like the Steam Workshop. I know people... I look for blueprints every now and then, especially props and small stuff. I like them because I don't like to build it, but I already said that. I'm happy that people do put stuff on the workshop because I know how hard it can be to do it. There you go, a roof. There's a roof on the monorail station. This is all outdoors, so if it's cold, if it's winter, the monorail is probably closed. I mean, it's the Netherlands, so we can't even drive a train here in winter. Yeah, that's all closed, and the entire country is blocked if we have 2 millimeters of snow. So yeah, that's the realism part in this Veluwe Zoo episode. Yeah, some nice flooring. I'm using these log pieces. I thought it was cool. Trying something new every now and then. I know I use the same pieces and same stuff very often, and I try to do some new stuff and try to experiment a little bit more. But you know, if it works, it works. You don't have to change it. So for example, this beam. Now, look at this. Like a handrail. Looks very nice. And some foliage around it. Foliage always finishes off the build nicely. Some more logs, changing the color of the stair, and raising it a little bit, so it looks nice. I fixed all the sea fighting on this one. And somehow with the temple pieces, it's really bad because it has this nice texture on it, but that also causes a lot of sea fighting, and I don't like that. So yeah, the pathing was a little bit raised over here. You can see smoothing it out, making sure it connects nicely. And then I'm putting some rocks here. Nice little staircase, bit of random stuff. And then I will finish off the fencing. I did get a comment about the fencing that I was using it too repetitive. So I'm trying to change that a little bit here. I see him rotating it a bit, two locks. So Timus, if you're watching, if you like it, hit the like button, and if you don't like it, also hit the like button. Yeah, let's say it like this. So a bit more foliage, and that will be it for today's video. So I hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you did, make sure you hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you do so you won't miss out on anything new. And I will speak to you guys in the next one. Yes, goodbye, you.